So how do you make more horsepower per pound of boost from your turbo? Let's find out. Hey guys, I'm Richard Holden, and thanks for watching. For the last 25 years, I've done nothing but direct back-to-back dyno testing. I've tested it all. Ford, Chevy, Dodge, import, domestic, 4-cylinder, 6-cylinder, 8-cylinder, heck, even 10 and 12-cylinder. I've tested all the parts, cylinder heads, camshafts, intakes, turbos, blowers, and nitro. I've tested it all, and it hasn't always gone right. But now I'm going to take all that information and a little bit of the craziness.
When the truck and trailer can't go through the drive-thru.
And bring it to you. On this video, we're going to take a look at the single biggest thing you can do to improve the amount of horsepower you make per pound of boost. Before we get to that, we need to calculate how much you make now. Then see what this big thing is, then take a look at the smaller ones that still help, just not as much. Before we improve how much power your motor makes per pound of boost, we need to calculate what you have now. And the best way to do that is actually with an example. Suppose we go down to a wrecking yard, my favorite place by the way, and pick up a 5.3 LS. Now it could be any motor, but we'll use a 5.3 LS as this example. We take that 5.3 back and put it up on the dyno. We run that motor naturally aspirated and it makes, let's say, 300 horsepower. Now a 5.3 will normally make more than that, but 300 makes for easy math. So we run the motor on the dyno, it makes 300 horsepower. It's important to note that naturally aspirated motor is actually running under pressure. 14.7 pounds of atmospheric pressure. That's right, your NA motor is actually under pressure. And that's an important point because if we take our NA motor making 300 horsepower at 14.7 pounds of atmospheric pressure, and we double that pressure with a turbo by adding 14.7 pounds of boost, if we double that pressure, we can also double the power output from 300 horsepower to 600 horsepower. That means if we run 14.7 pounds of boost on our 300 horsepower 5.3, we can make 600 horsepower. Of course, certain conditions apply. It's certainly possible to double the power output of our 300 horsepower NA motor to 600 horsepower with 14.7 pounds of boost, but a couple of things have to be right. First of all, the tune has to be spot on. You've got to run the right air fuel and the right timing. If you're trying to run 10:1 to make the thing safe, you're never going to get there. The thing needs to be 11:7 or so. Same thing with timing. Now, if you're trying to run 10 degrees because you're trying to run pump gas and keep it safe, that works well, but you're not going to reach this power output. You need to have enough octane to run enough timing to get the number. The last thing is intercooling. Now, don't get me started on air-to-air versus air-to-water. I'm going to do a whole nother video and compare the two and talk about the pluses and minuses of each one so you guys can argue all you want. But for right now, for this example, all we need is intercooling. It just needs to be functioning. It needs to work pretty well. So if we've got intercooling, we've got the air fuel, we've got the timing, we can double the power output at 14.7 pounds of boost. Now that we're all comfortable with doubling the power output of our 300 horsepower 5.3 liter to 600 horsepower with 14.7 pounds of boost, we need to find out how much horsepower per pound of boost that is. Well, and that's easy math. All we have to do is take the power gain, which was 300 horsepower, and divide it by the amount of boost required to get that gain. So we take 300 divided by 14.7, and we come out with 20.4 horsepower per pound of boost. Now, the reality is that each pound of boost wasn't worth the same amount, but it makes our math a lot easier. So what do you guys think? We now need to increase from 20.4 horsepower per pound of boost on up. How are we going to get there? Let me know in the comments before we get to the math. Before we improve the amount of horsepower you make per pound of boost, we need to take a look at something I call the 90% rule. Now, the 90% rule has two parts. The first is that this video is aimed at 90% of the enthusiast. Now, if you're a pro mod guy and you're making 2,500 horsepower, this video might not be for you, although it might because it applies to your street car. But it does apply to 90% of the people out there looking to install their first turbo or guys that want to learn more about turbocharging. There'll be some good information here. The next thing is the 90% rule also solves 90% of the problems. By that I mean when we look at something, in this case how much horsepower you make per pound of boost, we need to look at the thing that makes 90% of the difference. Now, there are a lot of little things that also make a difference, and guys will argue about them incessantly. But stay focused and look at the thing that solves 90% of the problem. And that's my 90% rule. We solve 90% of the problem for 90% of the people. Now that we've covered the 90% rule, we can increase the amount of power you make per pound of boost. So what did you think it was? The turbo, the intercooler, the exhaust? Actually, it's none of those. In fact, it has nothing to do with the turbo system. The best way to improve the power output you make per pound of boost is actually to improve the power output of the NA motor. What do we mean by that? Well, let's use our example. If we take our 300 horsepower 5.3 liter LS and increase the power output to 400 horsepower, let's say a camshaft, and then we apply 14.7 pounds of boost, what happens? Well, we double that power output of 400 horsepower to 800 horsepower. Now, I know what you're saying. There's no way the turbo's not big enough. But let's say we had an S475 BorgWarner turbo originally on our 600 horsepower 5.3. That will take us all the way to 1,000 horsepower. So it's not a turbo problem. Again, if we take our 400 horsepower cammed 5.3, run 14.7 pounds of boost, and everything is right, it now makes 800 horsepower. So if we divide that power gain of 400 horsepower by 14.7 pounds of boost, we now make 27.2 horsepower per pound of boost. We've jumped up 7 horsepower per pound of boost by increasing the power output. And guess what? It keeps going. If we now make a 500 horsepower 5.3 with heads, cam, and intake, that will make 34 horsepower per pound of boost. Because we've doubled the power output of 500 horsepower to 1,000, that 500 horsepower gain divided by 14.7 makes 34 horsepower per pound of boost. If we were to build, let's say, a 6 liter that made 600 horsepower, it would make 1200 horsepower, and that would be 40 horsepower per pound of boost. And then if we build a 700 horsepower big block, that would be 1400 horsepower. Again, assuming that you had the turbos to support that. But that's the way that it works. The single biggest thing that you can do to increase the horsepower you make per pound of boost is to increase the power output of the NA motor. Now that we've covered that, the big thing, let's take a look at the little ones. Before we get to the small things, we need to cover something very important, and that's this. This power boost formula works at any boost level. Now, for our example, we use 14.7 PSI because that was double the 14.7 pounds of atmospheric pressure. So we increased the power output by 100%. But if we were to run our 300 horsepower 5.3 at 7.35 pounds, which is 50% of 14.7, we would increase the power output by, you guessed it, 50%. So our 300 horsepower motor would add 150 horsepower for a total of 450 horsepower at 7.35 pounds of boost. Now this works at any boost level. Let's say we ran 10 pounds. Now 10 pounds is 68% of 14.7. It's easy math. So if we ran 10 pounds of boost, we'd increase the power output of our 300 horsepower 5.3 by 68% for a total of 504 horsepower. Now again, this works at any boost level. So I got a question for you I want you to answer in the comments. What happens if we run 29.4 pounds of boost or 2 atmospheres on our 300 horsepower motor? Let me know in the comments. Let's get to the small stuff. Now that we know the power boost formula works at any boost level, we can talk about the small things that also affect the amount of horsepower you make per pound of boost, starting with the most important one. That's obviously the turbo itself. Now, we're not going to go into things like compressor maps and that sort of thing, but let's just talk about, in general, the turbo is very important. The important thing to remember about turbos is that there's two sides. There's a compressor side and a turbine side. And both of those have to be sized to meet your power needs. If you're trying to make 1,000 horsepower, the compressor has to be able to support 1,000 horsepower. But the turbine side also has to flow enough to support 1,000 horsepower worth of exhaust. So remember, size that thing for the power output you want to get to. If you're trying to make 1,200 horsepower, use a 1,200 horsepower turbo, not a 700 horsepower turbo. And the same thing holds true. If you only want to make 700 horsepower, there's no reason to put a 1200 horsepower turbo on there, because the 700 horsepower turbo is going to be more responsive. Second on our list is actually intercooling, right behind the turbo. Actually, it's not intercooling so much as the temperature of the charge air going into the motor. You should do everything that you can to minimize the air temperature going into your motor. Not only is it safer, but it actually makes more power. If you were somehow able to get the charge air down below zero, you'd make a ton of power. That's why racers use ice water in their intercoolers at the track. Now, they can never get it down below zero, but if you can reduce your charge temperature below ambient, you're gonna do pretty well. What do we mean by that? Well, if you take your drag race car out on a 100 degree day, and you've got 300 degrees air temperature coming out of your turbo, if your intercooler will drop that to say 80 degrees, you're gonna make good power. If you can drop it to 50, that's even better. Now, in addition to intercooling, you should do everything that you can to get cold air to the inlet of the turbo. This means ducting an air intake, because if you're drawing air from the heated engine compartment, especially behind a radiator, that's a terrible idea. Do everything that you can to get cold air to the turbo and then cool the air after the turbo. The final thing we're going to talk about on our list of small things is actually the exhaust. Now, when it comes to a turbo motor, there are two types of exhaust. There's the exhaust before the turbo, feeding the turbo, and the exhaust after the turbo. So leave a comment. Which one do you think is more important? Is it the turbo before the exhaust or the turbo after the exhaust? Well, I'll give you a little hint. It's the exhaust after the turbo. That's the critical element. Turbos like as big of an exhaust as you can possibly fit after the turbo. Now, I did a cool video comparing a 3-inch exhaust to a 3.5-inch exhaust to a 4-inch exhaust on a big single turbo application, and the results were really impressive. Not only do we show power, but we also showed back pressure. So make sure to like and subscribe and ring the bell and do all that stuff to stay notified when we release that video. But the exhaust after the turbo needs to be as big as possible. Now, what about the exhaust before the turbo? Well, that's important, but to a lesser extent. You see, really all you need to do is get all of the exhaust from the motor up to the turbo. I know guys worry about having tubular exhaust and the size of the Y pipe and whether it's a merge collector and all that, but the reality is get all the exhaust to the turbo and you're gonna do pretty well. All of those other things are worth this much. I wanna thank you guys for watching. Make sure to leave comments. Let me know what you wanna see because I've tested a ton of stuff. So let me know exactly what you wanna see in the comments. Again, like, subscribe, do all that stuff. See you next time.